Good morning, students. Today's topic is Introduction to Image Processing. Myself, Kartlali, working as Assistant Professor in Kalyan Selangor University. Roadmap for my today's presentation is Introduction. What are all the key stages in image processing? What are all the applications, medical imaging application? What are all the imaging modalities present? How we are going to apply image processing techniques in medical images? Okay, I'm concluding with the remarks. What is digital image? Two-dimensional images, the finite set of digital values is called as pixels or pixel elements or pels. Okay, we are going to capture an image under the some sunlight. We are going to get to capture an image with the illumination. So the output is the input is the internal image plane and output is the digitalized image. So it is a view of two-dimensional image with the finite set of digital values. So each digital values are represented as the pixels or pels. So pixel values typically represent gray levels, colors, heights and opacities. Okay, the particular one pixels are represented in a particular image. Digitalization implies that the digital image is an approximation of a real screen. Okay. So what is digital image processing? Processing a digital image using digital computer is called as digital image processing. So what are all the problems we are going to address with the help of digital image processing? What are the techniques we are going to apply in digital image processing? Where we are going to apply? That is application. So what are all the problems? Oh, image enhancement, image restoration, image analysis, classification and segmentation are their subparts, image recognition, and interpretation, image compression. Okay, we are going to enhance the image, restore, analyze, recognize the images and compress the images with the help of technique called spatial domain, frequency domain, wavelet, some transformations we are going to apply, some image enhancement techniques we have applied, and morphological processing, soft computing tools, artificial neural networks and fuzzy based algorithms. Okay, these are all the techniques we are going to apply to solve those problems and on the images like medical images, satellite images and classical images. So images, what are all the images that we are going to process, like entertainment images, medical fields and forensic fields and remote sensing, we are going to apply images. What is the first step? Image acquisition. We are going to first capture the image. Okay, based on the problem, based on the application, we are going to capture the image. So image is a combination of illumination and reflection. Okay, image contains both the things, illumination and reflection. We are going to remove the illumination and the reflection by the help of image enhancement. So the next step is image enhancement. We are going to enhance the contrast of an image. We are going to brighten the image with the help of image enhancement techniques. Image restoration. Okay, what is the restoration? If it contains some noises like Gaussian noise, we are going to several noise, salt and pepper noise, Gaussian noise, we are going to remove those noises and we are going to enhance those images and we are going to restore those images to the original image. Okay, that is image restoration. Next one, morphological processing. What are all the morphological processing? There are four major steps of morphological processing present. This is morphological opening, morphological closing, morphological erosion and morphological dilation. What is morphological erosion? We are going to remove some pixels from an image to make the image more useful. That is erosion. We are going to add some pixels to make the image more meaningful. That is dilation. Okay, after that we are going to use opening, in the sense we are going to apply erosion, afterwards dilation, dilation afterwards erosion is called as closing. Okay, these are all the morphological operations present in image processing. Next one, segmentation. What is segmentation? Partition an image into meaningful region. Okay, we are going to otherwise we are going to partition image into sub image and afterwards we are going to enhance the region which is the needed one. Okay, that is image segmentation. Then object recognition. If I want to recognize some objects, like side some, I want to recognize a triangle or rectangle or some shapes. So boundary descriptors, we won't recognize some objects, I can able to recognize those objects. Afterwards, representation, I want to represent the boundaries and edges of a particular image. Okay, I want to represent the boundaries, and afterwards I want to connect those boundaries. Okay, that's called as representation and description. Afterwards, compression. Okay, that is original size of an image we are going to store there. I for sending to through emails, or I want to compress those images without any losses. That is called a lossless compression. If I am compressing the image, if there may some losses may happen, that is a lossy compression. There are two different kinds of algorithms. That is two broad areas. Okay, there are several algorithms we are representing the image compression. Okay, next, color image processing. There are different kinds of colors: RGB, red, green, blue. Hue saturation values, HSVs, okay, that colors, we are going to process those images with the help of color image processing algorithms. These are all the major basic steps in the image processing algorithm. First one is image acquisition, second one is image enhancement, third one is image restoration, and the fourth one is morphological processing, fifth one is image segmentation, sixth one is object recognition, and the last representation and description, and image compression and color image processing also available. Okay, so evaluation of diagnostic images. Okay, what are all the diagnostic images we are using? Anatomic images, that is MRI, CT images, functional images like Doppler scan images, MRI, PET scan, angiography images, hybrid images, we are going to combine those PET images or CT images, SPECT images and CT images, PET images and MRI images, and we are going to use those hybrid images, and molecular images like NM, PET, SPECT, MS, optical images, contrast enhanced MRI, US and CT images. Okay, these are all the algorithms. Where these are all the images, and medical imaging, why we are going to use those medical imaging. Okay, it is both, there are two types, that is non-destructive images, dynamic in vivo, or destructive static and once in a lifetime. Okay, these are all the two major types of imaging we are going to use. These are all the different kinds of medical imaging for brain, for chest, for thyroid operations, for breast cancer. Okay, these are all the transient x-rays, ultraviolet, thermograph for veterinary uses, for veterinary purpose. So what is medical image? Collection of techniques that are developed to display the distribution of a physical property in a human body. It is very useful. Medical imaging not only provides for diagnosis but also serves to assist with playing and monitoring the treatment of malignant diseases. Okay, all imaging rests on physics of the interaction of energy and matter. Different imaging methods are based on the separate physical interaction of energy with biological tissues and thus provide images of different physical properties of biological tissues. The value of the physical property may change from tissue to tissue, which leads to anatomical imaging. The value of physical property may change for malignant tissues, which is useful for diagnostic purposes. So this is the simplified block diagram. We are getting energy and the object is present and based before the detectors by based on some mathematical algorithm, it going to display as the object as the image. So what is the pipeline? What is the steps involved in medical imaging capture? Acquisition is patient, the subject to the imaging device, and pre-processing is going to perform. After that, image is going to reconstruct. After some interpretation, that is some based on some quantitative qualitative measures, then it is going to the physician. Afterwards, he is going to make some decisions. Okay, these are all the steps which is connected with the imaging device: pre-processing, reconstruction based on the things which he is going to make, interpretation based on some statistical processing. Here, physical property, that is density, absorption, conductivity is the input for an imaging device. It going to produce the output as the raw data. In pre-processing step, we are going to give an input as the raw data. From the get off of some prior knowledge, it going to pre-process. That is, we are going to remove some noise, contrast. We are going to enhance the contrast. And we are going to remove some outliers. And we are going to phase, time and space filtering is used afterwards. The same pre-processed data is given as an input to reconstructed image. It makes physically meaningful images, that is as a sequence of images, volumes, that is tomographic reconstruct, MRI and ultrasound. Afterwards, it is given as an input for an interpretation, high-level processing. It going to give the images a quantitative and qualitative information based on size changes, metabolic information. Here there are some types of medical images present. Image generations like visible light, infrared, X-ray, sound waves, radioisotopes, and a magnetic resonance. So based on where we are going to apply in endoscopic imaging, documentation, thermography, projection radiography, angiography, computed tomography, ultrasound imaging, gamma ray imaging, PET, and nuclear magnetic resonance images. Okay, these are all the X-ray imaging capturing device. This is the X-ray images. And this is my CT images. How I am going to take the CT images? It is invented by Godfrey Hospital in England. And next, this is the result of my CT image. So the next image shows the recent bleeding happened to a patient due to some injury. This is the CT images taken in chest. This is the bigger lower extremity arteries and aortas. This is mammographic image, the normal mammogram, some cyst in a mammogram, but not cancer. Here, them with the cancer cells. This is the ultrasonogram image for a single baby, but a twin baby. This is the magnetic resonance image of chest showing the heart and blood vessels. These are all the MRI images of a brain on different views. This is the fundus camera going to capture the image, retinal image. Retina is the inner layer of a right, going to capture the retina, macula, fovea, blood vessels in an eye. So what is diabetic retinopathy? And adverse changes in retinal blood vessels that leads to vision loss without any symptom. Early diagnosis due by the help of retinal images, we are going to identify the red lesions or hemorrhages and white lesions or exudates. They are going to identify the exudates and blood vessels, hemorrhages, and going to identify the severity of the diseases. Okay, these are all the things we can able to perform. These are all the stages, different stages of diabetic retinopathy: non-proliferative, proliferative, pre-proliferative, based on the presence of abnormalities. These are all the results. Just when I am applying the image processing algorithm, what happened? How I am going to apply pre-processing algorithm? How I am going to enhance my image? How I am going to segment my image? These are all the diagrammatic representation. How I am going to classify the image into stages, different stages. Okay, thermal image. It is a new area. We are going to, based on measures on surface temperature of the human body, we are going to measure the temperature, convert the infrared radiation emitted from the skin surface into electrical impulse, which is visualized into colors on the monitor. The blue color shows the cold area. Orange color shows the most highly temperature area, that is affected area. And this image shows the posterior back with the right sensory nerve nodes, and here it shows the pain in syndrome right foot, and here also in left wrist. Here breast cancer detection. Okay, thermal images helpful to identify the breast abnormalities. Different kinds of cancer, it also able to segregate the cancers with the help of thermal images. And also some original image, we are going to apply grayscale image, we get an edge reduction image. Afterwards, we are going to perform hub transform, and I am going to identify ellipse. If it is both the things are right, it is a normal image. This is how I am going to synthesize the medical images, image construction, image processing, and computer vision. Here, simples are in and images is out. Image processing, images are in and images are out. Here, computer vision, images are in. Finally, simples are out. So, we are using molecular imaging, several using image technologies, biological activities, and functioning. We are going to apply, we are going to identify. It is helpful for early identification, diagnosis, and the early changes. So these are all the different molecular imaging, MRI, PET, SPECT, optical imaging, targeted ultrasound. These are all the advantages. Medical image constitute main information for diagnosis and therapy, and also it helpful for surgery planning. It help to medical disciplines in many ways, in many things it going to help. So these are all the, what is the image processing, and what are all the things, what are all the basic steps involved in image processing. And finally, we are going to apply the in medical imaging, different modalities are present, what are the medical images we are going to apply the image processing algorithm. That's all. Thank you.